I'm Jane Salmon. I'm professor of medicine in the autoimmunity and inflammation program at the Hospital for Special Surgery.
And I'm Carl Blobel. I'm director of the arthritis and tissue degeneration program at the Hospital for Special Surgery.
In our paper that's being published by the Journal of Clinical Investigation, we uncover a new mechanism for rheumatoid arthritis, and we define a new potential target for treatment for this disease. But before we describe the details of the study, it's important for you to be introduced to the molecular players and the pathway we define.
So the first molecule I would like to introduce is called tumor necrosis factor alpha, or TNF-α. TNF-α is a very potent pro-inflammatory cytokine. You normally need it to defend yourself, but when it's dysregulated, when you have too much of it, it can cause autoimmune diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis. Therefore, TNF-α is currently one of the main targets for treatment of autoimmune diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis. TNF-α is made with a tether that attaches it to the cell, and that tether needs to be cut so that it can work on other cells and promote inflammation. This tether is cut by a pair of molecular scissors that are called the TNF-α convertase, or TACE. And in the case of rheumatoid arthritis patients, that is something that you would want to prevent. Therefore, TACE is considered a target for treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. But there are potential side effects, and we know what those could be actually from a patient who has no TACE and who was described last year. This patient has a skin barrier defect and has a tendency to intestinal inflammation, which tells us that TACE has some protective functions in the skin and the intestine. The next molecule I would like to introduce that regulates TACE is called iRHOM2, and that is what this paper is about. So iRHOM2 was independently discovered by three groups. One was a collaboration between our lab and Dr. Tak Mak at the University of Toronto, with his student David McIlwain. The second was by the Nobel laureate Bruce Beutler from UT Southwestern, and the third group was Matthew Freeman from the University of Cambridge. All three groups noticed that if you inactivated iRHOM2 in mice, you actually lost the production of TNF from myeloid cells. So one of the questions that were raised by these studies, if you can block active TACE, why do mice that don't have iRHOM, why do they not look like mice that have no TACE? Why do they not have the skin defects and the intestinal defects that you would expect to see? Our paper provides an answer for that. We found that outside of immune cells, iRHOM2 knockout mice actually have mature TACE, and it seems to be functional. So this is a very exciting result for us because it suggests that by inactivating iRHOM2, we can in fact inactivate TACE in a tissue-specific manner without interfering with its protective functions in the skin and in the gut.
As a first step, we isolated macrophages from the synovial fluid of patients with rheumatoid arthritis and found that they had dramatically increased levels of iRHOM2 compared to control macrophages. So the next step in looking at the role of iRHOM2 in rheumatoid arthritis was to establish a mouse model. For this, Priya Issuree, our graduate student, and Thorsten Maretzky, a postdoctoral fellow, and Lionel Avashkiv, a colleague at HSS with a great deal of expertise in rheumatoid arthritis mouse models, set up the KBN model of rheumatoid arthritis.
The protection of the iRHOM2 knockout mice from the inflammatory arthritis model suggested that TACE in immune cells is important for the pathogenesis of this mouse model for inflammatory arthritis. To specifically test this, we used mice that lack TACE only in immune cells, not in other cell types in the body, and subjected them to the same model for inflammatory arthritis. We were excited to find that these mice were protected to the same degree from inflammatory arthritis as mice lacking iRHOM2, very strongly suggesting that iRHOM2 protects from inflammatory arthritis by inactivating TACE in myeloid cells.
C5a and immune complexes are critical triggers of tissue injury in rheumatoid arthritis, but it's never been clear exactly how they cause injury. There are obviously many pathways, but the release of TNF is quite important. We performed a series of studies using macrophages from patients and from mice, as well as in vivo mouse studies, to show directly that C5a and immune complexes, which activate Fc receptors, trigger the activation of the iRHOM2 TACE pathway to release TNF-α and thereby cause tissue damage. This is really the first demonstration of a linkage between initiators of tissue damage, that is immune complex and complement activation fragments, and the downstream mediators of injury, TNF-alpha. And we potentially can target that pathway in novel therapies for patients. We're hoping to develop monoclonal antibodies to specifically block iRHOM2, and these may be very exciting treatments for rheumatoid arthritis.